and a wrong. Nobody likes a movie where there's no right and wrong. Lord of the Rings would suck if there was no right and wrong. But there is. Why? Because in the very core of human nature, we know there is good and there is evil, and they are at war for your soul. So the Bible says, this is good, this is right, this is evil, run. That's true. But on the flip side is when you screw that up, because you will, there's grace. And grace is unmerited favor. Grace is what you don't deserve. See, you do deserve death, but because of grace, because of Jesus Christ, you come, you not only do not die, you have life, and life more abundantly. It is only by grace that you are able to live a life of purity. Because after you do fall, the Bible says a righteous man falls seven times. And Micah 7:8 says, though I fall, I will rise again. Though a righteous man falls and falls and falls and falls, he will rise again. Because of grace. It's pretty amazing. See, if you're all into truth, and there are people like that, all into truth, they're legalists, they're old, even if they're young, it's not about who's old, they're boring, they're dead, and they're legalists. And so they come up with all these rules that are not in the Bible, not about the Bible, not about nothing, with long dresses and long hair and no jewelry and no this and no that and no nothing and no fun and you suck and we're going to be bored all the way to heaven because all they care about is truth. And they don't understand. No, there's also grace. Now, grace on the other side, people say, man, I'll do whatever I want. I'll live however I want. I'll screw up. It's all good. I'll come to church. I'll be at the altar. I'll say, what's up, God? And well, I'm good. That's not a correct understanding of grace, because when you've really encountered grace, when you've really experienced grace, you realize grace is actually a person. It is the person of Jesus Christ. And once you experience Jesus Christ, your desires are not to use Jesus Christ like some cheap hookup, one night stand. No, you, when you really meet Jesus Christ and you really want to have a relationship with him, you do not come to him once a week and say, what's up? We're good? Okay. You say, Jesus, I'm so sorry. Jesus, I need your help. Jesus, help me. God, help me. I tell you, that's the word. Jesus, help me. You need both. You need to know what is right, what is wrong. When you screw up and you go to grace, you go to Jesus Christ and say, I need to get back up the way, the direction, the pathway to purity. Is this making sense to you? Are you getting this?